Well, that's how T20 works. Sometimes you go for runs in the first two overs, sometimes you go in the last over. So that's how, like, you know, it depends. If you go for the runs in the first couple of overs, so how strongly you come back. And then at that time, I was just planning to, you know, to get some wickets, because that was the only thing by which I can contain the batsmen, because they were going it pretty well. Like, especially against me, they were taking their chances and they hit it quite well. So second spell when I came back, so my just one aim was there, because they were you know, required rate was somewhere around 11, so I know they're gonna go after me, so I just need to bowl in good areas. Well, it totally depends, you know, on the situation. Sometimes you need to fly the ball, sometimes you don't. Like, sometimes the batsman just comes and walks, and no matter you are bowling the 17th or 16th over, you still tend to fly the ball just to, you know, take that extra bit of risk to get the wicket. It totally depends on the situation. Well, the flats are pretty good here. Yeah. Like, if you see, most of the flats are very good for batting. This one is a little bit on the slower side today. It wasn't turning that much, but still, it was a little bit on the slower side. But you still need to bowl in good areas to get the wickets. Experience is always good, because as we all know, he's a good bowler, and you can see the class. Because, you know, after so much of ups and downs, he still came back strongly, and the way he bowled, like just four overs for 28 odd runs, and that shows the class.